Hey guys, it's AB Gearax, and welcome back to another episode of the Pokemon Gold Tagalog series with Tim. So, I trained a whole new team up to level 20 off camera, and I did make some catches as well off camera, and I'm going to show you guys one of them right now. It's probably like one of the best catches we've ever had so far. A Scyther with 81 HP. That is awesome. It knows Quick Attack, Ball Swipe, Focus Energy, and Pursuit. So this Pokemon's going to be helpful against next-gen thanks to Pursuit. Even though it's Special Attack, but yeah, Special Attack is pretty good. And it's, with the 55 attacks, getting 43 speed, that's really good. So Scyther's going to be really helpful for a while. But unfortunately, it doesn't learn any Bug-type moves by leveling up, and the only Bug-type move in the game, which is Fury Cutter, cannot be taught to Scyther because Tim already used the TM on Sandshrew. So that's just gonna be fantastic. And speaking of Sandshrew, here he is right now. I'm just gonna let you guys look at these stats real quick.
And Sandshrew is getting close to evolving.
Whew. It's so tired. As you can see, Rocket's attack stat's still really high. Be helpful against the next gym thanks to Mudslap because that ability hasn't been, since the Levitate ability has not been introduced yet. Then Shintoki into Zubat. Hopefully this fight will be really helpful, and it will hopefully be even more helpful once it evolves into Golbat. Of course, its highest stat is Defense. Then we essentially the Butterfree, because it can use Confusion, which will really help it. Ghost types in the gym since they're all poison types. Ghost poison types, bleh. And it learns stun support and supersonic. And of course, we attack you with the Quilava that Tim renamed off camera. And it didn't really learn anything new yet. And of course, its stats are still okay ish, but still kind of garbage. So in this episode, we're gonna hopefully make it to Ecruteak City. Oh yeah, oh, I almost forgot to show you guys the other Pokemon that I caught and were trained off camera. So I'll show you guys real quick. I caught an Aggro off camera, which is 40 HP, which is, I think, slightly above normal. There's 26 special attack stat, which is pretty good. Hopefully this thing will be better once it evolves into Kadabra than Alakazam. And Tim, just for making me battle all the trainers, and thanks to Tim battling all the trainers above me, he gets to train up the Abra.
Revenge.
I also trained up Slowpoke to level 20 off camera, and it did learn Confusion, but because his defenses are garbage and it's a ghost type gym coming up, I don't think Slowpoke would do so well in that gym. Also, Itsuka the Spear evolved into Fuhrer. Fortunately, I think its HP is on the lower end of the spectrum, but I like its speed. Its defenses are also really, its defense is really good, but its attack stat, not really. But it may be helpful against the 5th gym. Pretty sure Tim will most likely use it.
My dog doesn't freak out.
Okay, so we're about all these trainers in this park. Of course, I did, in order to get Scyther, I entered the bug catching competition earlier today. And I did win, and your prize for winning first place is the Sunset. So hopefully, we get Sunkern or Oddish, we can hopefully get the Sunflora or Blossom. Alright, so let's use a quick attack. How much damage will that do? Almost one shot. So we use another quick attack. fight a pincer off camera as well, but it detects that is kind of garbage. I should probably stay in the grass in case I find a stun card. Let's go, you. And speaking of Yaddish. Yeah, Voltorb, we'll go for that real quick attack. Okay, he missed me in there. I'm not gonna be making any catches in this area unless the sun crack appears. I'm a Oddish, so let's use a quick attack and one shot it. The Cubone, it's the first time I've ever seen one. So I'm gonna send Sand Shrew to front for this battle. Okay, I guess we'll start with the Fury card. I think it's time to fail. And hit a bear shot for the Fury card, we'll still be able to knock it out. And yes, we'll be. Alright, how close is second to leveling up? 10. Ooh, come on, really? I just need a quick attack to get the level up. I guess we'll send Sandshrew. Actually, I'll send Chitoge to the front. Since I believe there's a trainer coming up ahead that only has Abras and Kadabras. Oh, but I almost forgot we had to get all these items from behind the fence. This item will be a fertilizer, which is okay. Now, go all the way around here. We find the TM28 for Dig. I'm gonna hold off on changing to Sandshrew now, because I don't wanna waste a TM if its attack set ends up being horrible when it evolves. Oh yeah, and I'm not sure if I mentioned this yet, but I tried to record this episode earlier. But the game decided to just close out in the middle of recording, so... And I didn't save, so I kind of lost everything. So yeah, that was kind of annoying. I'm going to choose Bite since I'm going to turn on special defense. Another Bite. And Kadabra. That might be a bit of a problem. Let's start with Confuse Ray. That confusion did nothing, even for a Kadabra. I understand it's part of the, because the Kai level was lower, but still, that's pretty pathetic damage if you think about it. It was lucky you would have hit some confusion. We'll keep using Bite. Oh, critical hit, nice timing to Chitoge. And I have no idea if I pronounced this name right. Get some of our health back. And, okay, get like 2 HP back, probably. Or 1. And then Chitoge leveled up. I guess we'll put Sandshrew to the front. Like, wasn't it supposed to be that Gory you're supposed to? You're supposed to talk to so you can get the. What is that? The watering pill or something like that? Unfortunately, I do not have cut on me, so I can't take the shortcut to that tree. One thing I should probably do is heal up. you ever got the square bomb? I believe Jim did guess the bike, right? Yeah, I just got registered. You might as well ride it. So, one thing I'm gonna do, because I know I made this mistake in my Crystal Nuzlocke, I'm gonna get that radio card right now. So, to answer some questions, and if I answer them all correctly, I will be able to get the radio card for the Pokégear. Which I'm happy to display on a Pokégear. Yes. Can Nidorina arena only be female? Yes. Does Kurt the Pokéball? Yes. What? Oh god, it was just a mis- you just misspelled that, didn't you? Fine. Yes, yes. No. Magikarp won the need can't lose, that is correct. Professor of Pokemon Talk is a very popular program. Is Mary the co-host of the show? What? It's like a really weird color for Sunkern. I wonder if it's shiny. No, I'm just kidding. Probably isn't. I want to catch it anyways because there's a possibility that we could get some floor later on. One, two, and of course. Mega Drain, okay. Sandshrew, you're getting switched out. Who has the weakest attacks? Toge, but Leech Life is super effective. I'll send attack you. And hopefully attack but won't kill it. There we go. Now I'm just gonna throw the Great Ball Eye. Now check what its stats are. What? Didn't even go up by once. Didn't even reach it once. One, two, three. Got it. So I'm not familiar with all the sprites. Let's see what your stats are like. Well, you're just like any other Sunkern. You're very garbage. How are we doing our Great Balls? I'm pretty sure it's starting to run a bit low. Yeah, I probably better go back and stock up on some more Great Balls. I think you have the balls, don't you? Yes, you do. Alright,
I'll buy 99.
Nope. That's 550. For now. And, yeah, I think I'm gonna post this as well, so I guess I'm gonna sleep right now. So I can leave. Try not to use the speed up button when trying to go upstairs. Or downstairs. Okay, so now it's time to go in battle at Sudowoodo. If it's high attack and speed, I might consider adding it to the team later on, or at least him start doing that. You know, I'll send Rocky to the front. If it is like no defense, I don't think a mud slap would be enough to kill. Alright, it's time to catch this Sudowoodo. Alright, Rocky. Use a mud slap. And okay, then you Okay, it's gonna do a lot. Oh god, that did a lot of damage. Alright, let's crash this thing ASAP. 1, 2. Oh, and of course, Shinwoo doesn't have the best catch rate. Rock throw missed, thank goodness. Yes, considering switching to Sash Shape, would that be a mistake if he used Rock Throw again? But we got it anyways. It's probably worth letting Rocky die then taking me out with Butterfree. And of course, I'm gonna talk to you in order to give me Rock Smash. Alright, so we're gonna check out Shinwoo's stats right now. Stats like 72 HP is really good. Whoa! Your attack stat is really good. Having no special attack, that's fantastic. But you have like no defenses. Ugh. You have nothing in your defense stat. Like, this is a really good Sudowoodo. It is another Pokemon that's worth considering adding to the team later on in the adventure. Actually, what are your moves? Rock Throw, Mimic, Fail, okay. Mimic, I'm probably never going to use, unless it's Mimic Ghost type gym. That's actually not a bad idea, now that I think of it. But for now, let's just head into this next round. I just battled all these trainers. I took the puppy and I did not kill him. You still be able to one shot the Jigglypuff. And yes, you will. You can fade. Rock throw. And you can go down as well. You're pretty keeper, I believe. Alright, now your second trainer. Choose rock throw, and you go miss. And yeah, you're Rocky. Goodbye. Sancho. Use your fear card. Almost one shot it, and use the stable. It doesn't matter, I'll just kill you with Swift. I'll make your loss Swift. Yeah, you kill me now. I wonder what kind of Pokemon make your. Oh, it's Gamma, that's actually rare fine. I've never even caught this Gamma before. Nor have I even. Oh wow, that special effect must be really high. Two more Pokemon, no more Pokemon, a single one's main. Send Psycho. Jackal, how much damage is that gonna do? Yeah, I'm not messing with you because you're a really bad attack. Alright, we have arrived at Ekrogene City. So, oh wait, that's Bill. That's right. We're not going to be using that trade casually anytime soon, since this is an emulation of the game, and our trade with Red, you can't even trade in this game, for that matter. And so I might go back and get the EV gold rod off camera. And yeah, I guess this might be a good point, good time to end off the episode, since I've been recording for almost 20 minutes now. So as of right now, it looks like our time is up. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to check out my other videos, and I will see you guys next time. Peace!